Hello everyone, welcome. Today is June the 18th, 2020. A day where the best students from Africa, best doctoral students, are making their presentations. This is group two. We are on a course AC812 for those who are in the master's group and AC912 for those who are in the doctoral group. And the course is Advanced Strength STEM Education and Graduate Seminar. So in the graduate seminar component, yesterday we had group one, today we are having group two. And our first presenter is Adebanjo Adesina. We are going to listen to his presentation on the impact of ICT and multimedia resources on instructional delivery in selected tertiary institutions in Nigeria. Over to you, Adebanjo Adesina.
Good morning, sir. Thank you very much, sir. My research proposal will focus on the impact of ICT and multimedia resources on instructional delivery in selected tertiary institutions in Nigeria. It will interest you to know that distinguished Professor K. Bukola is one of the leading witnesses to facilitate the use of multimedia resources in delivering lessons. The emergence of ICT has changed the global status of education. Multimedia instruction was offered alternative to traditional method of learning, has made learning more meaningful, accessible, interactive within and outside the classroom. Multimedia are instructional materials and interactive applications that integrate text, color, graphic images, audio, animation, audio sound, and full motion video in a single application. However, Nigerian universities have not fully embraced the use of multimedia instruction, teaching and learning, as we can see during the COVID-19 lockdown. Most tertiary institutions find it difficult to migrate to multimedia resources as a means of lesson delivery. This will lead me to a statement on my problem. There have been several negative reports on instructional delivery of STEM subjects. Accused fingers are raised toward teachers' commitments, inadequate funds, and teaching methods of STEM subjects, among others. It becomes necessary to seek for other resources that can promote instructional delivery of STEM subjects. The purpose of this study is to find out the impact of ICT and multimedia resources on instructional delivery of STEM subjects in selected tertiary institutions in Nigeria. This result of this study will serve as a guide for government in planning and implementation of STEM curriculum in line with an Afrocentric approach. That was the voice of Dr. Gulei, June 2020. My research question goes as follows. What is the awareness level of tertiary institution facilitators on the use of ICT and multimedia resources in teaching STEM students? What is the awareness level of tertiary institution managers, head of faculties, vice chancellors on the use of ICT and multimedia resources for teaching STEM students? What is the gender awareness level of lecturers facilitating STEM students? Are there adequate ICT and multimedia resources that can facilitate STEM student performance? My methodology goes as follows. I will adopt a survey type of descriptive research by administering instruments on the representation of the target population for generalization of the entire population. The population will comprise of all universities in Nigeria. The target population will comprise of 6 selected universities in line with geographic zone in Nigeria. A total of 24 universities will be selected from Nigerian universities based on geographical zone: North Central, Northwest, Northeast, Southwest, Southeast, and Southwest. In selection of these universities, name of the university will be written on a strip of paper, out of which 6 universities will be picked at random based on zone. In each of these universities selected, the head of science faculty,
2 minutes more.
A STEM assistant lecturer and 10 STEM students will be randomly selected for use of, will be selected, giving total of 240 respondents. Data gathering, online data gathering using Google Form will be used. Instruments, The main instrument that we use for the studies is self-developed questionnaire for STEM students, head of science faculty, and lecturers. The questionnaire will be divided into two sections. Section A will seek for information on background of the respondents. The information will include the name of the school, that university, type of respondents, gender, qualification, and level of computer literacy. While Section B will seek for information on respondents' perception on the IT, impact of ICT and media resources on instructional delivery.
1 minute.
I will have ten items. Four like a scale of strong agree, disagree, and strong disagree. Validity. The question will be subject to criticism by my colleagues, and contribution will be used. I will ensure faith validity and content validity. While reliability, I will use a factor analysis. That analysis, response from the question will be pooled together for scoring, and I will analyze, and answer will be pooled. Descript statistics, percentage, frequency count, integral statistics of TTL will be used, that is IBM SPS version. While the procedure will be as follows, I will generate instruction letter from the university, I will link up with universities, I will answer the questionnaire, and I will strip back the questionnaire. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Very well done. Good presentation. You stayed very well within time. I can't see any of your reviewers here. Oh yeah, Elemora Sadiq, are you here? I thought I had him. Okay, he's not. Okay, the floor is now open for two people to make some comments. Who is doing that? Oladejo. Yes, go ahead, Oladejo.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead, Oladejo.
Thank you very much, sir. Well done for your presentation. I just like to point attention to something. You mentioned of two things. Multimedia and ICT.
Yes.
I don't know whether you have the version of terms that differentiates in between those two in this modern era. That is one. Look into that. Number two, you talked about collecting your results from vice chancellors. How do you hope to get access to this level of officers at this time? Thank you.
All right. Thank you very much. Is there another person who want to ask? Michael Adewusi, yes. Over to you. Michael Adewusi, over to you. Okay, he's not ready. Any other person? We can't hear him.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Fred. Fred, take the floor.
Yeah, thank you very much, sir. I just thought to that. I saw him use a word like link up. I'm just thinking that it's not appropriate for research. So right. It's a link up of the university.
Yeah, you know he's a military officer, so he's going to link up. Adebola, yes. Okay, Adebola is not
Thank
ready.
You, sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah. I just want him to make his point clear on the choice of the number of university he has.
Adebola, if you can hear you after Adebola, that would be nice. Yes, well, go on.
All right, sir.
Yes, sir. So I just want him to make that point clear. He mentioned 6 university and later mentioned 24 universities. So you need to clarify that point.
All right. Thank you. I'd like to hear that word, IES, at the end of this thing. He mentioned 24, don't say university, universities. I'd like to hear that S. Like some people will say, I bought it for $20. It's not, there's an S after it. So everybody should watch out for that. Yes, Adewusi.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Concerning the area of the reliability, he was talking about test, retest. I don't think he needs to have something like test, retest, since he's not doing anything that has to do with achievement. So that's just it, sir.
Okay. Let me just let you know that you've spoken very well. But it's not only achievement test that you do test, retest for. You can do for any instrument, you know, whatsoever. You see, the instrument, the test it is a coefficient of stability, how stable that instrument is. So, but you've done very well, Michael. AJ Michael, thank you. Right, over to you, the presenter.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, sir. On the issue of terminologies, I will actually put down a consideration. I'll put into my research. And as we get to 15 of universities, have friends everywhere in part of throughout the country. I have friends everywhere. We can link up. I will send mail to them. They'll do that for me.
And now, hold on. Do you think anybody, even if it's a, what service are you? Are the Air Force?
Yes, sir.
You think any air marshal can walk into my office as a vice chancellor? You think you want to pull rank?
I retire from the wisdom, sir.
No, I'm just joking. Just use all the connections that you can to be able to reach the vice chancellor. I can help you, definitely.
All right. Thank you very much for that, sir.
You can intimidate anybody by saying you have friends everywhere. What's your rank in the Air Force? What's your rank?
I'm flight lieutenant, captain of
Vigilance. What can you fly? Can you fly a MiG? Can you fly an F-15?
I can fly C-130.
That one. I'm just joking. Quickly round up.
Yes, sir. The issue of... the top question, I do not get it very well.
Okay, don't worry. We'll be interacting with you on it. But I've enjoyed your presentation. You've done very well.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah. All right, so let's all together give him a round of applause. Appreciate the flight lieutenant. Better clap for him, because when you want to take a flight from Lagos during lockdown position, we use the C-130. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Well done.
All right, sir.
Yeah, after listening to Adebanjo, we are now moving in to listen to Franklin on Owubeda. So, Franklin, please take the floor.
Thank you very much, sir. And I'll be presenting on the proposed study for publication titled An Assessment of Cultural Techno-Contextual Approach and Flipped Classroom Strategies on Senior Secondary School Student Critical Thinking Skills and Attitude Inspiration and Evolution. It's not surprising that, to date, ineffective teaching strategies, among other factors, contribute to the underperformance of students. And this study is aimed to compare the effectiveness of CTCA and flipped classroom, because limited study have examined the combination of CTCA and other teaching strategy. The main research question to guide this study reads thus: would there be a statistically significant difference in A, critical thinking skills, B, attitude of students in variation and evolution using CTCA, flipped classroom, and lecture method? Learning experience of this study will be based on variation and evolution from students enrolled in public and private school located in rural and urban areas. This study is focused on a quasi-experimental pre-test and post-test design involving two experimental and one control group using a quantitative and a qualitative data gathering technique. The population consists of all senior secondary school to biology students in Lagos State Education District 5, and the sample is proposed to be 232 SS2 biology students from four selected schools into strata of public and private in rural and urban areas. Four research instruments will be used to collect data for this study. And face validity and content validity will be subject. The instrument will be subjected to face and content validity. Thereafter, the instrument will be reviewed by students with similar characteristics to ensure that the items are comprehensible by these students. Durability of the instruments will be tested using test retests of stability, Cronbach alpha, and integrator. For the procedure of data collection, the researcher attempts to train some research assistants for about 2 weeks. Thereafter, after all formalities have been established, he conducts the pretest in the schools, and the treatment will be given to the three groups. The experimenter will be treated with CTCA and flipped classroom using variation and evolution. Then the post-test will be conducted, after which the administration of questionnaire will be done 2 days or 3 days after the post-test, which will now lead into conducting of interview for selected students and go further to give a retention test after about 4 weeks of administering the post-test. And then the researcher tends to go back to the control group to give them the treatment of the CTC approach. For data analysis, multivariate analysis of programs will be used to analyze the data, because randomization was not achieved. But before that, the data will be subjected to test of parametric assumption. And if the Levine test failed, the data will be subjected to Welsh test. Now, after certifying all these conditions, the pre-test and post-test of the control and the treatment group, likewise, the attitude data will be inserted into the Mankova equation using IBM SPSS version 20, and this will be followed by univariate F. Now, when a overall significance is achieved, Sheffield post-hoc test will be conducted to know exactly where the difference is coming in, and then the qualitative data will be coded for imaging teams and graphical representations would be listed. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so very much. Frankly, I know whether if I were in a conference and you made this presentation, I would think that you are the professor Anello department of STEM education in that place. I'm telling you, Franklin, you know, I'm a very, you know, I just say the way it is. You are a superstar. This is one of the very best. You can see Ige is even nodding his head. Ige, who's reviewing you? The very best I've seen around. And I'm looking forward to your going to carry the banner of LASU. By God's special grace, when you finish, God will let us keep us in good health so that you'll be a professor in one of our universities, publishing in volume 20 and above, not volume 1, volume 10, number 3. All right. So, Ige, you have the floor to comment, make a question, observation on this.
Thank you very much, Franklin. Dr. Franklin, you've done well. I just want to add to what you said. Since I'm in the field of biology, I want to ask why, since evolution and variation is an SS3 scheme of work, why do you want to use the class SS2? Thank you very much.
All right. Ige, I think you can answer that question yourself, but I'm going to wait for Franklin to provide an answer. Yeah. Akikwotu Adebimpe, you have the floor, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for the brilliant presentation, Dr. Franklin. This is top class, I would like to work as one of your researchers, if you don't mind. I have some comments. For the scope, I want to believe we are not going to all the public and private secondary schools, so I would like you to include maybe Lagos State, so it can be geographic. Also, you did a great job with the quantitative aspects, but for the qualitative method of data collection, you talked about an interview guide, but you did not tell us how you will use the instrument, if you are going to be doing a focus group interview or an in-depth interview. Also, you need to tell us how you'll be selecting your respondents for the interview. For the interviews, is it going to be purposive or incidental? Finally, since you are using human subjects and you need informed consent, especially for these young students, may I suggest that you include ethical considerations? Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, Dr. Franklin.
Okay, thank you very much. There's somebody now. Let me call on Franklin Onowubeda to provide answers to the observations and questions.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. If I got Ige's question right, he's asking why I'm using variation and evolution as the learning experience. A study conducted in 2019 revealed that...
Not as a study experience. He said that okay. Variation and evolution is a topic in the SS3 syllabus. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes,
but
I can, sir.
That, why do you want to now... It's a topic in SS3 syllabus. Now you want to teach it in SS2.
Yes, sir. Okay, now I'm teaching SS3 content to SS2 because SS2 students have not had a learning experience of this. So my teaching them would measure effectively if
brilliant.
Any of the approach I use is effective.
Brilliant. Brilliant, Ige. I'm wondering why you asked that question. Will you go, if you were to conduct the study, so you go and teach SS3. That have learned evolution and genetics, then there's no, you can't, it's confounding. They have learned the thing before, so on what basis will you then, but I'm sure that you just asked that question rhetorically. Yeah, continue, Franklin.
Yes, sir. Based on the interview, I tend to select randomly about, let's say, 5 students from the class I teach to have their view on their attitude to biology. And other comments made by Dr. Binke will be put into consideration in respect to the selection of the schools in their geographical location. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you very much. And on that note, I'd like all of us to appreciate very much Franklin Onogbeda. I'm telling you that of all the presentations I've been having for 1 million years ago, this is one of the best. It is just classy, classy. It covered all the grounds, and this is showing us that we are really moving in this class. Our next presenter is Dansu Taiwo. Taiwo, are you standing by?
Yes, sir.
All right, that's fine. Yes, we are now taking on the third of the presentations for today. That's Group 2. Group 2, Graduate Seminar Series, AC812912, Advanced Trends in STEM Education and Graduate Seminar. He hasn't got his name on this slide, so maybe he will tell us his name. Like you normally will do, when you put the title, you should put your name under the thing. That would answer, you have not obeyed that. But go ahead, take the floor.
Thank you very much, sir. My name is Taiwo Dansu, and I'm presenting this research proposal titled Impact of Indigenous Knowledge System and Practices on Secondary School Students' Comprehension and Entrepreneurial Skills in Chemistry Concepts. Firstly, I want to tender unreserved apology for omitting the second dependent variable in the title. Okay, the background of the study, Indigenous Knowledge System, we said to compose of the knowledge of given community or society. And in a way, that's a way to contribute to a meaningful learning for upcoming scientists. Also, it has been shown that overloaded curriculum overburdens students and also shifts their interest out of the context of the interest. The statement of the problem, it has been seen over the years, and studies have also shown that the focus of educational goal have shifted from what it ought to be to another thing, and have brought about the diploma disease like we were taught some months ago. Next slide, please. Yes, the purpose of this study will be to examine the efficacy of indigenous knowledge on students' comprehension and also break barriers to comprehension of chemistry concepts and, of course, entrepreneurial skills for chemistry students. I have highlighted here some of the research questions. 5 of them have been set for this study, but I have 3 of them on this slide here. Will indigenous knowledge system have any statistically significant impact on secondary school students' comprehension? Also, the second one will be checking for the impact of indigenous knowledge on students' academic performance. And then lastly, the third one here will be testing on the impact of the correlation between indigenous knowledge system and students' entrepreneurial skill. The significance of this study will be to challenge students' creativity and their ability to solve problems, which is the main basis for education. The study also is going to be provoking students' innovative and transformative ability. The developmental of entrepreneurial skill also will be part of the things that will be brought about as a result of this study. Next slide, sir. The review of the related literatures will cover the theoretical view by the theory of Vygotsky's social theory. And also the meta-analysis will also be adopted in gathering quality-related studies for this study and evaluating what have been done so far in regard of this study. Next slide, sir.
Very good.
The research design for this study will be the mixed research design. The mixed method research, sir.
Better.
The population of this study will comprise all students in Lagos State and in Educational District 5, to be precise. sample and sampling technique of this study will involve a random selection of 5 schools within the educational district 5 of Lagos State and a total of 105 participants. The research instruments to be used in this study will involve 3 instruments, or let me say 2 instruments, one of which is going to be a 2-in-1 instrument. The first one is the chemistry concept comprehension test, which is to test how much the students have understood of the selected concept. Also, the next one is the skill acquisition assessment to assess how much skill have the students acquired. Also, the second part of the SSA will be to interview the students to ask them what have been learned and what have changed about their entrepreneurial skill. The reliability of this instrument will be test and retest method. The Kronbach alphas will also be used to test the reliability of the instrument. Now to the data collection. It's going to begin with the getting acquisition of approval from the center so the expected schools can be properly carried along, and then we'll seek their approval to carry on the study using their students. Also followed by pretest and then the treatment, and then after it we'll have the post-test. For the SSA, is going to take the format of pretest, treatment, and then post-test, and then the interview using a questionnaire, like I said earlier. For the data analysis, the Pearson's correlation will be used to test the relationship between indigenous knowledge system and students' entrepreneurial skills. And of course, ANCOVA will be used to measure and analyze the quantitative data. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you so very much. Very well done. Very well done, Taiwo. Very well done. So I'm going to call on your reviewers. I think we have just one that's in the house. That's Francis Onyewuchi. Francis, I know you're having a challenge with your technology, but
yes, sir. Yeah, thank God I read the PowerPoint before time. Otherwise, I'm not seeing anything. However, sir, I want to begin from the title. I want to ask Dansu, are you regarding indigenous knowledge system and the practices as just one variable?
Yes, sir. Exactly, sir.
No. Don't talk yet. Just make a note.
Okay, sir.
With reference to your research question 3, will you be collecting data on entrepreneurial skill? And again, somewhere you made the mention of meta-analysis. The meta-analysis you are going to embark on, is it this type that we were taught recently? And finally, in your instruments, I didn't see interview guide, focus group discussion, or observation schedule. How will you get information about the indigenous knowledge? Thank
Very
you.
Good. Thank you. Dansu, Taiwo, you have the floor.
Thank you very much, sir. And thank you very much, Dr. Francis. Let me start on the first question, sir. The topic, like you asked, the indigenous knowledge system and practices are actually regarded as one variable. That is the independent variable of this study, sir. Then to the second question, regarding the research question 3, you said, am I going to test? I didn't get the second question well. I can't remember that. The second question, sir.
No, go on to another one. Don't worry.
Okay. You said something about the entrepreneurial skill. I explained during the course of the presentation that the students will be trained on acquisition of this entrepreneurial skill. You know, in the presentation, in the slide, you see some of these local pictures. There are 2 basic entrepreneurial concepts that will be taught. That's the making of black soap, which can be innovated by the students into whatever they can, you know, improve their entrepreneurial skill to do, as well as the process of distillation. So that is going to guide on that. And then the next one is on the meta-analysis. Well, this presentation is a proposal. I'm still in the learning view of the meta-analysis. And I believe by the time we'll get to that point, before getting to that point, the requisite knowledge for meta-analysis I would have acquired before that time, so that it can be properly applied.
You can see Oladejo is excited. Brilliant answer. But also brilliant question. Francis asked, this is not this meta-analysis we are just being taught that you are, but that's the idea. That's the idea of you deploying or using all the things that we're teaching you. And I'm so delighted that Taiwo Dansu is doing a few issues here and there, but this can be cleared up over time. It's a proposal. We'll be sharing our thoughts with you on how you can close all those gaps. Any other question for him? None for now. So we got to appreciate him.
I want you to help us.
Yes, go ahead, Francis. Go ahead. Your microphone is still muted. Francis, your microphone is still muted.
Yeah, can you hear me, sir?
Yes, sir. We can hear you now.
Now, this issue of indigenous knowledge system, it is one entity. Then cultural practice or indigenous practices is yet remain another entity.
Yeah.
So, but from the way he has put it, indigenous knowledge system and practices, they're supposed to stand as two independent variables.
Okay.
That's my view about that.
Your view is very correct. But what I suspect that Taiwo Dansu is trying to do is to embed the two of them together, the knowledge and the practice. I think he's trying to aggregate them together into one, the two, one being subset of the other, so into one. I think that's what he's trying to do. But as he mentioned, it's a proposal, and we can keep fine-tuning. You are a senior doctor. You are a senior doctor, so you are going to guide him as he proceeds. All right, so that's it. We will give Taiwo Dansu. I think we have given you a round of applause, have we? Let's do that again.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir.
That's fine. We'll now move on to the next presenter. We have two more, and we'll do those very, very... We'll now proceed with the fourth presentation of the day, and we've had three men speak. Now we're going to have a lady, speak. And it's interestingly, the two presenters that will close this group two session are ladies. So my pleasure to invite Deborah Oluwatosin Agbanimu to make a presentation. Yes, what
you? Thank you very much, sir. The title of my proposed paper for publication is Effects of Cultural Techno-Contextual Approach and Cooperative Learning on Problem-Solving Skills and Attitude of Students in Algorithm and Flowchart. Judging by the quality of students who go to the university to study computer science, majority of them find programming language very, very difficult. And this is as a result of low understanding of algorithm and flowcharts. So the purpose of this study now is to look into the effective way in which algorithm and flowcharts can be made less difficult for students to understand. And this research question is there a statistically significant difference in the problem-solving skills and attitude of students taught using the CTCA and those taught using the cooperative learning? This study is going to adopt a mixed method of qualitative and quantitative for data collection, and the question, and also question experimental, which is for the pre-test and the post-test that's going to be administered to the students, and also experimental and control. And I'm going to have two experimental and two control. The two experimental is the CTCA and the cooperative learning, then the control group. Then this study is going to take place in Lagos State with all SS1 students offering computer studies in the Lagos State Educational District 5, about 120 students from selected public and private school. And I'm going to have an intact class because I'm not going to be using a selection procedure. The research instrument is going to be the problem-solving skill test. Then there's going to be a computer attitude questionnaire and also computer studies interview guide, which the students will be randomly selected to ask questions to know more about their attitude towards understanding algorithm and flow chart. Then I'm also going to adopt the classroom observation schedule, which is going to be time sampling for the class. And I'm not going to, this research work, the researcher is going to train the teacher, the subject teacher, to on about CTCA. So it's going, the teacher will have to take the students other than the researcher having to take the students. Then the instrument will be laid open to phase and content validity to make sure it measures what the target variable also. Then for the reliability of this instrument, I'm going to be using test, retest, inter-rater, Kroeber Kappa and factor analysis. So the test itself is to measure the consistency over time, that's the stability of the instrument. And also I'm going to be using the entire rater to know if the particular scale is appropriate for measuring the particular variable. Then I'm going to be using the Kroeber to test the internal consistency. Then procedure for data collection. The first is the ethical consideration, which is to obtain full consent from the school for the study. Then I'm going to conduct the pre-test on the experimenter. Then after 2 weeks, I'm going to control the post-test. Then the interview on the selected student that will be randomly selected. And then the retention test, which is going to come after a month. Then after the whole research procedure, I'm going to conduct the treatment again on the control group so that they can also benefit from what other students, other experience as the experimental group has had. Then the procedure for data analysis is going to be a makeover because I have two dependent variable interests, and it's going to measure and analyze my quantitative data. Then the analysis will be, which will be done using the IBM SPSS, and the qualitative data will be coded for other emerging terms, and it's going, all data that can be represented will be represented graphically. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. Our reviewers Akkad, you have the floor. Njuwimana, Akkad, you have the floor.
Okay, thank you, comments there.
Thank you.
I have two comments.
Yes.
The first one is on the topic of the, yes, the topic. Would you go back to the topic?
Okay, I will. Just a minute. Yes. There you are.
Yes. It is just a comment. A look at the topic shows that, yes, it seems that the researcher is very ambitious. I'm going to explain why, and I'm sorry to use the term ambitious. The researcher is going to investigate the effect of two approaches. That is CTCA and the cooperative learning. The effect of these two approaches on two variables, problem solving skills and attitude. And not only in one course, but in two courses, that is algorithm and flow chart. In my opinion, it is very ambitious, but if she sees that it is feasible, there is no problem. But for me, it is very ambitious.
Okay.
Another comment
I'm very proud of you. Very proud of you. Please go on, yes.
Yes, another comment is on the introduction. After reading the introduction, the problem under investigation is not clear.
Okay.
Normally, it is expected to find the status quo of the problem and then the desired situation. There should be the gap between the status quo, the present situation of the problem, and the desired situation should be clear.
Yeah.
And this is just two comments that I have.
Oh, wonderful. Dr. Akkad Nduwimana, this is brilliant. Very, very, very good. Very good. So let's take on the second reviewer. That's Faith Igbo. Faith. Okay, Faith Igbo, if you're not ready. Franklin, take the floor.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. I just have a comment for the
presenter, and it's based on her validation exercise. Because taking a cue from what Dr. Aouve told us from his experience, she'll have to subject those instruments to the student, because those instruments are meant for the student, so they can see if the items there are comprehensible for them, or they are not understandable. So it is advisable to give the student the instrument. So thank you.
Thank you very much. Is Faith Igbo back? Okay, she's not. Now let me yield to Deborah Agbanimu to respond quickly.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Pertaining to my topic that has algorithm and flowchart, the reason why I'm having algorithm and flowchart is because it was after the study conducted last year on difficult concepts in computer studies, we found out that algorithm and flowchart is one of the topics that the student find most difficult. And for students to have a basic understanding of programming language, they need both the algorithm and the flowchart. They need to understand those two things. It can't be only algorithm, because they are the step-by-step method in which problems can be solved, and they have to be able to graphically represent it in writing their codes. Thank you, sir. And a comment by Dr. Franklin. Yes, I'm going to subject the validation to the student. The validation will be subjected to the student. Thank you.
All right. You have not finished. You didn't respond to Dr. Akat's question. He asked you that you are looking at two independent variables. You are looking at two dependent variables. You are looking at all of this. Is it not too ambitious? That's what he asked you. You didn't answer that.
Okay, to me, it's not. I think it's just fine.
Okay, that's fine. That's all right. So that will be it for Deborah Agbanimu. You did very well. You are a star student, and let us appreciate her for a job very well done. And to thank our reviewers too, Dr. Akad Unduwimana, I really appreciate your comments, your very useful comments, and also Franklin. We're taking on our last presenter. Unfortunately, we are not able to get Esther Peter to present because he has some challenge with audio connection. In that wise, we'll be adjourning for today. Next week, we are going to have group 3, 4, and it will be as exciting. So, class, that is it for today. I wish you all the very best in your discussion forum contribution, and I wish you every success tomorrow in your test. Mind you, we have on Saturday the practicals, the workshop for the qualitative analysis. And the matter that Francis raised about qualitative, I think he's talking about meta-analysis. The meta-analysis one will come, the following week, and then we'll have Professor Bill Kyle come to give us a workshop on how to publish in international journals. So, on behalf of the center leadership, we can see that our Deputy Center Director, Professor Tunde Wolabi, has been with us all along. You have been scored, by the way. At the end of the series, we are going to publish your scores for your presentations. So for now, it is bye-bye. Bye-bye from...